Hey guys, what's up? Happy Saturday. So in this video, I'm going to share my favorite films from the 90s that I think you guys should watch. Okay, let's just get straight into it. First up, Reality Bites. Wow, what a film. During the 90s, there was a revolution in the film industry and the music industry. New type of films started emerging from Hollywood, you know, the more indie look films, the more raw feel kind of films, the more soundtrack-based kind of films, you know, and Reality Bites was one of it. It changed how I looked at films. It's about a group of friends, of course. It's about friendship, it's about hope, it's about dreams, it's about life after college and university. It's about love, the classic tale of heart versus mind, passion versus corporate world, you know, that kind of thing. And yeah, what I like about films from the 90s is that it had a strong underlying value and message to it. You know, back then, people still believed in love, in hopes, in dreams, as opposed to building walls. Right. So Reality Bites stars Ethan Hawke and Winona Ryder, or as many of you may know her as Will's mom in Stranger Things.
Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I'm out of my mind.
So yeah, this is Reality Bites.
I'm making this documentary about my friends, but it's really about people who are trying to find their own identity without having any real role models or heroes or anything, but...
Wow.
I truly believe that if we can get two women on the Supreme Court, we can get at least one on you, Sam.
Your friends would be perfect for that.
And it's not even happening to me. It's like I'm watching it on some crappy show like Melrose Place or two, right? And I'm the new character. I'm the HIV AIDS character. And I live in the building and I teach everybody that it's okay to be near me. It's okay to talk to me. And then I die.
Melrose Place is a really good show.
The world doesn't owe you any favors.
See, lady, this is all we need. A couple of smokes, a cup of coffee, and a little bit of conversation.
Why'd you get a job at Burgerama?
I was valedictorian of my university.
Well, you don't have to put that down in your application.
I don't have time for your little mind games. I'd like to remind you that the lame people off around here, and I can find an intern who'll do your job for free, like that.
I was really gonna be something by the age of 23.
All you have to be by the age of 23 is yourself.
Are you religious?
I guess I'm a non-practicing Jew.
Hey, I'm a non-practicing virgin. You say.
She breaks my heart again and again, but. But I love her.
You say I talk so all the time.
So.
You look beautiful. You look like a doily.
And I thought that I don't belong. And now that I am leaving, now I know that I did something wrong.
Okay, so if you have the time, you can watch Reality Bites, though I do advise no kids because the language can get a little bit meh. Okay, so next up is, if you're into serial killers, if you're into mystery, if you're into solving murders, if you're into detective stories, if you're into Morgan Freeman, and if you're into Brad Pitt, then Seven is a movie you must watch. I think it's on Netflix now. This is a twisted one. So it's about a serial killer who goes killing people, who commits the seven sins: sloth, gluttony, vanity, and so on and so forth, you know. What I like is how, as gory and as crazy as this film is, I like how the director carried us into the plot, you know, made us follow and get attached to each of the characters. And then bam, once it takes a turn, you're not ready for it. one of Brad Pitt's earlier films, and I think you guys should watch this if you're into these kind of things. Take a look at Seven.
Do you like what you do for a living? These things you see?
You have to wear blinders sometimes. Most times.
Detective William Somerset is looking for a way out.
You're retiring. 6 more days and you're all the way gone.
So how long have you lived here?
Too long.
Detective David Mills is looking for a way in.
We'll be spending every waking hour together from now until the time I leave. I'll show you who your friends and enemies are.
Look, I'm going to come inside 5 years. Not here.
Now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a homicide.
They're caught in a game.
No fingerprints. No witnesses of any kind.
Nope. About the only thing we know about that guy right now is he's totally insane.
Where the price of sin is death.
There are 7 deadly sins. Gluttony.
You're going to come take a look at this.
Greed.
No one touches anything.
Sloth. Wrath. Pride. Lust. And envy. 7. You can expect 5 more of these.
Body was found on Tuesday morning.
I hate this city.
I'm gonna get who did this.
This will be the very definition of swift justice.
There are 2 more bodies, 2 more victims.
This guy is methodical, exacting, and worst of all, patient.
He's laughing at us.
He had a gun.
He's 2 murders away from completing his masterpiece.
Hey!
Finish it.
Brad Pitt, Morgan Freeman, Gwyneth Paltrow.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
No.
7.
Okay, if that's not enough, this next one is easily top 5 favorite films of all time. Usual Suspects. It starts off pretty random. You don't know what's going on, so you follow the detective in his interrogation room. So basically that's how it starts. It's very well done, very well told. Kevin Spacey gave an excellent performance. Agent Coulion, awesome. And it's about Kaiser Soze. I can't say too much because you need to watch it for you to know it. It's one of those Shawshank Redemption kind of films. Cannot reveal anything too much. And it's a one-time watch kind of film. Because once you watch it, you know the twists and turns, you know the ending. So, I mean, yeah, watching it again is fine, but it's never the same as the first time. Usual Suspect, guys. Watch it.
Usually, when there is a crime, there is a motive.
I want to know why 27 men died on that pier for what looks to be $91 million worth of dope that wasn't there.
Usually, when there is a lineup, there's only one real suspect.
This whole thing was a shakedown. And there's no way they'd line 5 felons in the same room.
But this is not the usual crime. This is not the usual motive.
He was in the harbor killing many men.
Kaiser Soze!
He saw Kaiser Soze.
And these are not the usual suspects. Keaton.
I'm a businessman.
McManus.
There's nothing that can't be done.
Hockney.
What, you got a team of monkeys working around the clock on this?
Fenster.
Flip you. Flip you for real.
Verbal Kint.
Roger, really. People say I talk too much.
He doesn't know what you want to know.
I don't think he does. Not exactly. But there's a lot more to his story, believe me.
In a world where nothing is what it seems.
The greatest trick the devil ever pulled.
He's here.
Was convincing the world.
I know he's here.
He didn't exist.
You've got to look beyond the usual suspects.
I'm smarter than you. And I'm gonna find out what I wanna know, whether you like it or not.
I work for Kaiser Soze. He feels you owe him.
He does not expect all of you to live, but those of you who do will have $91 million.
It was Kaiser Soze, Agent Kuyan. I mean the devil himself.
I'm telling you, it's Kaiser Soze!
There is no Kaiser Soze.
Keaton always said, I don't believe in God, but I'm afraid of him. Well, I believe in God. And the only thing that scares me is Kaiser Soze.
Okay, let's end it on a happy note. This is my go-to film or my go-to movie whenever I wanna laugh, whenever I wanna chill with my friends. I don't know what film to watch, I'll play this. Empire Records. You know how I said there was a revolution in music and film industry? It's exactly like this film in Malaysia as well. You know, you have this small record store, this small cassette shops that you go to, you feel like home shops, you know? Auntie Victoria in Pertama, in Bukit Bintang. Once the big boys came, you know, the Tower Records, the Salem Power Station, all these smaller shops started closing down. So we started losing all these people. So Empire Records is about one such shop. It's a small shop with, you know, loyal customers. And a big shop is coming, and so they're closing down. So it's a story about this group of friends who work in the shop. Again, this story has an awesome soundtrack. It's a fun watch, and if you want to watch it with your family, I think it's a good film to watch it with your friends or your family. And yeah, here's a snippet of Empire Records.
Just let me introduce you to everybody. This is Gina, Roy, Lucas, AJ.
The staff of Empire Records had the coolest jobs on earth.
Do you think the story is already written, or do you think a bold and courageous act can change the course of history?
Something happened to me last night in Atlantic City.
Did you win anything?
No, I did not.
But Lucas blew it. Everyone knew it.
You want to buy Empire?
Well, that's a good thing, right?
The money is gone.
Where's it going to?
I think it's recirculating.
We're turning us into a music town?
I have to pay for what Mr. Brilliant here did.
I'm the idiot. You're the screw-up, and we are all losers.
Now, five friends have one day to decide what to do with the rest of their lives. AJ loves Corey, not the whole story.
Today is the day that I'm gonna tell Corey how I feel about her. That I,
love her.
Yeah.
Do you think that it's possible for someone to be in love with someone else and not even know it?
In this life, there are nothing but possibilities.
That is so sweet, I think I'm gonna barf.
Corey wants Rex first time at sex.
Hey, Rex, what happened to your hair?
I will offer myself to Rex Manning. I wish I could be brave.
You are brave.
I have to bring Rex's lunch.
I'm bringing Rex's lunch!
Mark's raging mad. Best day he's had.
Just like that!
Help me.
If I was in a band, they would not be doing this to me.
Deb shaved her head and made out she was dead.
I tried to kill myself with a lady bit.
Just your typical nutty teenager.
You did have hair, right?
I was tired of being invisible.
Gina did it again, this time to a friend.
You get smarter the shorter your skirt gets.
I want to sing in a band, but I don't have the guts.
Is this how your life's gonna be now? You're just gonna screw every husband?
I'm starting!
Want to know more? Check out the store.
Empire Records open until midnight. This is Mark. Midnight!
Empire Records. Featuring the music of Better Than Ezra, Gin Blossoms, Ape Hangers, Evan Dando, Toad the Wet Sprocket, and the Cranberries.
What is wrong with you people?
Rock and roll.
Well, baby, I don't want to take advice from.
And a few other films worth mentioning. I think Mallrats, that's a good one, that's a funny one. Jurassic Park, Part 1, that's the first time I remember, you know, watching a life-size dinosaur in a film. High Fidelity is a film by John Cusack and his best friend, Jack Black, also running a record store, and it's about him dealing with a breakup. High Fidelity, awesome film, John Cusack. Love him. Yeah, I think that's about it. So, you know, if you have time, you can just go through films from the 90s. It's got a certain soul to it, that era. And yeah, and I'm glad to be a part of OAG, as we were also a part of that musical revolution. Yeah. Well, anyway, I hope you found your movie to watch tonight. And yeah, take care, stay safe, and stay sane. Assalamualaikum.